Hi, lovely people. Welcome back or welcome to my channel. I am Sylvia Mandro and today we're going to do a full face of Catrice Cosmetics makeup. Well, it's going to be almost full face because I'm missing my primer, my setting spray, brushes, but I don't know if they have brushes and sponge. So we'll see how it goes. I tested some of the products out before. It's not a first impression, it's just testing out their products. Some of them are new. And I also have the prices in euros for you. So, well, have some fun, enjoy. And this full face of Catrice only costed me 75 euros. So for a full face of makeup, that's a good deal. So I hope you enjoy. If you're gonna stay here with me, then please subscribe, press that notification bell and give it a like. And if you want, give it a comment, give me some tips, whatever you want. You can stripe it in the description box below. And if you want to know the prices and not watch the video again, all the prices, the products, everything is underneath in my subscription box. So if you want to know anything, check that out. And let's just enjoy and put a face on. I'm going to start with my primer, which is from Elston Luminous Body Primer. We're going to start with the Catrice HD Foundation. This cost me €6.99. And this is in the color 020 Rose Beige. And I'm just gonna drip this all over my face because it's the easiest way to do it. Because it's quite thin, but it has really good coverage. This is the one product I had also a little bit longer in my collection already. And because I like this so much, I figured I'd try the rest of their things as well. So I tried some of the stuff already out before to know a little bit about them to make sure I have a feeling for them already, how they work the best. And we'll see. There are also some stuff I haven't used before. So we're gonna play with that as well and hope it works. I also have an eyeshadow palette with nude colors. And that's the one I didn't use yet. And in there, there's a sculpt powder, which I'm gonna use for contouring. So we'll see how that goes. And we're just gonna enjoy ourselves, play with makeup. If you have some of this stuff, then try it with me. And if you have tried it already before, tell me what you thought of them. Because this foundation I've already tried a couple of times, so I know I love it. It's really good. I bought it because of Make Me Up Missa, who's also an amazing YouTuber here on YouTube. And she uses this regularly. And I had to try it out and I really loved it. And I figured let's try some more stuff from Catrice. And see if I love it just as much as I love the foundation. I'm going to put it on a little bit more on here and on my spots. Just put it a little bit of that foundation on a plastic tablet. And I'm going to use my BH Cosmetics brush in 8. And use it to put a little bit more foundation on my spots. I've seen people, a lot of YouTubers and all use concealer for this, but I only have a little bit lighter concealers and I don't like it because then you accent your spots and now it's just the same color as your foundation because you're typically using your foundation for it. A little bit more on my cheeks to hide my redness, a little bit more here, here, and then I'm gonna go back in with my sponge to tap those spots out. None of the palettes have a mirror, so I'm using my Amazing Jeffree Star pink mirror. I just have this one, not more colors, because I love pink. So foundation done. Quite good coverage, as you can see. I love the color on me, it's really nice. And now I'm going in with a liquid camouflage concealer from Catrice, and this is in the color 005 light neutral, and this costed me €3.45. So really, if you try this stuff, it's really a bargain. And I tried this one once before already because I wanted to know how this was, and it's actually really good coverage. And it's a small doe foot, but I kind of like it. So, and I'm gonna go back in with my beauty blender, and I'm gonna use the pointed part to really get in my corners of my eye. Now I'm going in with my glow fixing powder, and this is €5.45. I'm going in with my Boosie Shop tapered highlighter brush. This is the number 3300. You can see this, but it's also giving a very nice glow. And I'm gonna put it a little bit on my forehead. That's the only place I get ollies on my forehead. I think I didn't know if I tell this, but I have normal to dry skin with just oily on here, and that's it. So I'm not using too much powder, just to powder the parts that need it. Now I'm going in with my eyeshadow palette. This is the Fresh Nude Collection. And I'm going to use this darker shade, which is just Sculpt, to contour my face. Never used eyeshadow on my face before. I don't know. It says Sculpt on it. I don't know if you can see it, but it has the letters Sculpt in there. So I figured I'll give it a try. And I'm going in with my Boosie Shop contour brush. I'm going to squeeze a little bit to get it on there. And I'm gonna try it. I'm gonna make funny faces now. Ooh, that was very, very pigmented. Let's see if we can blend this out. Even though I used a little bit, a lot. Most honestly, it looks really nice. Let's see a little bit close. I quite like that, I must honestly admit. It works well. Under my cheekbone. I think that quite worked, actually worked quite well. Now I'm going in with the light shade of this palette because it works so well. Along with another contour brush. This is the Angled Buffer Blender, all from Boosie Shop. This is the number 1700. And I'm gonna squeeze it again. Tap it in. Tap it off a little bit. And with this I'm going underneath. This just not to bake it, but to make the lines nice. And with that, I'm going to blend this a little bit down my neck. So there's not such a harsh line underneath there. And that's my contour on. I must honestly say, my skin looks really good. Now I'm gonna go in with my Sun Glow Bronzer. This one costed me €3.95. And this is a matte bronzing powder. And for this I'm gonna use an angled brush from Wish. It's a marbled collection. And I'm just gonna... This looks really nice, bronzy. I'm actually quite shocked at this, I must admit, for such cheap, affordable makeup. It looks really nice. Looks really nice on my skin, doesn't feel sticky at all. Really nice. Now I'm going in with my blush. This is a Glowing Multicolor brush in Dolce Vita, and this costed €3.95. And I'm gonna put this on with my Kiko brush number 10. It's also an angled brush. This also has very nice pattern in it. This looks really cool. And I'm just gonna put it on my cheeks in a V. Oh, that's nicely glowy. Now I'm gonna go in with my Luminescence highlighter. This is actually almost the most expensive thing on the list. This is €6.95, just 4 cents cheaper than the foundation. So it's even cheaper than the eyeshadow palette, which I have like. And this is what it looks like on the inside. Quite nice, actually. You could also use this one as a bronzer topper, I think, if you want a little bit more shine in it. And I'm gonna go for the middle one, because the first one says on the back it's a soft highlighter. And I don't like my highlighter soft, so I'm going for the middle one. And I'm gonna go in with an unnamed Morphe brush from the eye set. Just dab it on a little bit, and let's make it glowy. I must honest admit, I don't know if I was expecting it to be this good, but it's really good. My skin looks amazing. Every product until now has worked just fine. Really like it. I hope you can see this as well from your side of the camera, but for me it looks really nice. Not creased anything under my eyes. Normally it's creases a little bit there, but nothing yet. Really nice. That's my base done. I'm gonna go in with a little bit of setting powder, but it's not Catrice, so let's just skip this part. If you wanna know, I'm gonna go in with a L'Oreal Shake and Glow. I'll put all the products I'm using, inclusive the prices from the Catrice range, underneath my description box, so if you're interested, just check that out. I don't know if you can see, but this is also giving me a little bit of a glow. And if you want a good, affordable setting spray, then get this one. It's really good. The spray is amazing. I think it's as fine as my Morphe setting spray, so it's really good. So now I'm gonna prep my eyes and I'll be right back. Now I'm gonna go back in with my eyeshadow palette, and I'm gonna start with the darkest color on this side, and I'm just gonna pop this in my outer corner. I don't want to do anything on stream, I just want to test out the eyeshadow palette and see how pigmented it is. I'm going in with my Morphe M506. Just pop it on the outer corner. See. Okay, not that much fallout in the pan. But I do have to build it up a little bit to getting the desired color I want. It's not as dark as I thought it would be out of the pan. Okay, now I'm gonna blend this out. I'm not gonna put anything extra on my brush. I'm just gonna go in a little bit with the left, with what's left on my brush, and just go a little bit. In my crease. Or honestly, a little bit above my crease, because my crease, I've got quite hooded eyes, so I'm always putting the shades above my crease so that if I look straight ahead, you still see my color. So like you can see here, it's folded now completely, and you can see it's sitting a little bit above it. So if I look straight on, my camera is a little bit higher than me, so that's why I'm not looking at the camera. But if I look straight ahead, you can see just have a little bit of eye space. And the rest is just folded in, so that's why I always go above. So that the eyeshadows are still visible when you're talking to someone or anything. Because I always also wear glasses, And if I put my glasses on, that is gonna be less. So normally I do a little bit extremer look, but because I wanna try this palette out, I'm not going extreme. I'm just putting a little bit on. A little bit mirror in the corner. Again, blend this out. Okay. Now both eyes are on. Like you can see, you can still see on both sides. The same. So to blend this out, I'm going in with a pinky shade in this palette. It has a little bit of a shimmer in it, but not much. And my favorite color is pink, so I'm gonna try that one. And I'm going in with my Jessup to the 3 Petite Eye Blender. And if you're starting like me, then the Jessup brushes are on Amazon, and they're actually really nice, and they're not as expensive. I bought just the eye set, and I would like to have the face set as well, or the eye and face set, but I cannot find it yet in pink, and I really want this pink. So I'm going in around it, around that first color, and then completely into my inner corner. Just to make it a little soft, pinkish. Really blend this well in the brown shade. I must say it's a little bit more salmon colored. When you put it on the eyes, and the palette looks a little bit pinker, but nothing wrong with that. That's why I just trying it out, of course, to see. But I must admit, the pigment in this one is better as in the other one, but still really nice. You can build it really nice, and for that price, I'm quite impressed. I don't have that much affordable eyeshadow palettes. Most of mine are high-end, but this is really good. Yeah, let's blend it out. Like you can see, if I look straight ahead, you can still see the salmon color above it. Now I'm gonna go in with this very light shade, which I used before to help my contour blend out. And I'm gonna use my Boozy Shop Tapered Blender Blush. This is a little bit flatter. Take this. Will not be that visible, but it's just to blend out the edges. Oh, that's a little much. Oh, okay, that's really, really pigmented. For a light powder, going back in with the pink. And I'm gonna take a little smaller brush. And this is the Morphe and Jeffree Star, the GS12. I'm gonna go back in again with light, and now really carefully blend this out around the edges. Yeah, that's better. This is also just to directly highlight my brow bone. Make it a little lighter, cover up my, well, I like it. Really blends really nice with the salmon color. A little bit back in the salmon color, just a little bit. Get the color back in there. Now I'm going to go in with my Jessup 237 Detailed Shader Brush. And I'm going to go in with the lightest shades of this palette, which is a sort of a metallic shimmer. And we're gonna put this all over my eyelid. I'm gonna start with using a dry brush. And we'll see where we go from there. Wow. Okay. I'm not gonna wet my brush. I'm quite shocked. This looks really nice. Yeah, I'm impressed. I'm honestly impressed. Blend this out, going back in with the darker shade, the same brush I used before, and again in with the same shade to blend this all together. Well, I've nothing but good things to say about Catrice. Really nice. Going a little bit above it to blend that out. Yes, that's all fits in nicely. Back with the shade I put it on top. Just on this side where I applied the pinky one. Going a little bit here to make it a blend. Yeah, I love it. Looks really nice. Not too extreme, just to try out all the colors. But I must honestly admit, for a 5 euro palette, it's really, really good. I love it. To be honest, I never tried a 5 euro palette from any other brand. I would like to try the e.l.f. Bite-sized palettes, but we can't get it in the Netherlands yet, so hoping that's coming soon, but this is really good. Now I'm gonna go in my lower lash line, and I'm gonna do this with the Creative Cosmetic brush number 7. It's just a flat brush, and I'm gonna start again with the darkest color in the palette and going underneath the eyes. I'm not going that far in, can I? Just to try it cohesive on the other side, because I've cleaned the brush on my color switch, and now I'm gonna go back in with the salmon shade. And now I'll bring it completely into my inner corner. And around. And now from the shade with light and the palette. If you want to try out one of their other eyeshadow palettes, they had more. This just was the cheapest one, and I figured I'd try this one first. And if I like it, I can buy more. If you want to see another video of full face of Catrice, but just with some different products, tell me. I have to check if they have much of different ones, so, but I'll buy more and see. So I'm actually really impressed. I like it. Still have a couple of products to go, but yeah. I think my eyes are done. At least for eyeshadow. Now I'm going in with my brow pencil. This was 2 euros and 95 cents. And I got the color dark. Has a spoolie on one side. And just, yeah. Ooh, very small. Nice. I mostly don't do my eyebrows with this. I mostly just put colored eye gel in it, but they don't only had a permanent one, and I didn't want to use that, so I'm just gonna try to darken it a little bit where I want that. To make it look a little bit more fuller. Try to make a little bit point. Tail. Sorry. Okay, nice. Yeah, you can see the difference. Brush it out. I'm still don't have anything bad to say about Catrice. It's really good. Now I'm going to go in with the Lash Brow Designer Shaping and Conditioning Mascara Gel. And it says you can use it for lash and brow. I'm today going to use it on my brows. And this Lash Brow Designer also just €2.95. Now I'm going to do my bottom lashes first. Not my top lashes, because I got to put on false lashes. Because they even have false lashes from this brand. I don't think I'm going to show you putting my lashes on, because I'm not that good at it. But we'll see what we're going to do. Quite like that brush, especially for my under eyes. It's not too big. Oh, the mascara was €3.95. And I'm going to be in my lashes, which is also €3.95. And we're going to try. I'm going to use the glue that's in here to see if that works anyhow. Start with curling my lashes first. Ooh, this has a very, very thin bend. My tweezers. Get my lash glue, I think. Have any tips or if I'm doing it wrong, tell me. Now I'm gonna go curl my own lashes. Let's see if this works. I hope you can see this. It's easier than I thought. Let's do the other one. This went way faster than I thought. I did try it yesterday. Lashes from Eyler. And those weren't that easy. But they had a black lash band a little bit bigger. I don't know if that makes any difference. Well, let's try this. I can sit like this. I think you can see it a little bit better. I hope so. Get my other tweezers and put the bands in the right spot. It's not sticking. Yep, seems like it. To put them on right? Yeah, I think so. Well, let's be real with you. They're on there. I'm not gonna take them off even if they're not the same. That seems to be on there as well. Let's wait a little bit to let them dry. And then we're going to coat the bottom with mascara to stick them together. Well, that went better than I thought. Looks quite nice. Going back in with mascara. To make it a little bit more black. These my lashes to fit in with those lashes, I think. Now I'm going in with a lip liner. This is the Aqua Ink Lip Liner, also long lasting. And this is the color Just Follow Your Rose 020. It's €2.95. So again, good price. Oh, this has a different kind of tip. It's not a pencil. Yeah, the ink liner says, of course. But okay. Let's go for this. Oh, that feels wet. Really nice. Ooh, that works quite easy. Yeah, I like that. That's easy. Really easy. That's nice. And this is gonna be my last and final product. This is the Power Plumping Lipstick. And this is €3.95 and I have the color 040. And this is Confidence Code. It's cold. And it's a little bit pinky. It's a little bit lighter. This was really dark, we'll all see. Oh, this is really nice and creamy. This is well my lipstick on. Yeah, lovely people, that's my makeup done. I actually really like the results. I just checked, I've filmed by right over an hour. So it was supposed to be an hour for the foundation and everything on. It's not correct anywhere. Normally it's correct on my fine lines under my eyes, but nothing wrong with that yet. Yeah, I'm thinking of products that I liked it all. It's really good. I have nothing bad to say about these products. I'm actually in shock. They were not expensive, they were cheap, but they're really good. I like the coverage on the foundation. It covered almost anything. You can still see my big ass pimple there, but yeah, well. We have them all occasionally. Yeah. Eyes are not that extreme, but really nice. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed yourself. I hope you had fun. And if you did, please subscribe, give it a thumbs up, and press that notification bell. And I hope to see you in the next video. So,